Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hey everybody, welcome to a Magic Online Cube Draft. I opened a pack here with a Planeswalker, a Johnny Goldmane, not a particularly good one. Consecrated Sphinx, one of the best 6-drop finishers. Damnation, really solid, role player type card. Similarly, Oblivion Rings, good removal, and Pristine Talisman is not the strongest of the artifact mana, but artifact mana is really, really important in Cube. Finally, I'd like to mention Tinker, which is... a really, really powerful and unique card, but I feel it's pretty overrated, or maybe I should say just not very good in the decks that I like to draft. I think you need like 2 extremely powerful targets and like 4 or 5 cheap disposable artifacts for Tinker to be at its best, which definitely does happen, especially if you first pick it and build around it. But I'd rather just not gamble on it, take a card that's guaranteed to be really strong right here. So I'm going to go with Consecrated Sphinx with, I think, a pretty close second being Pristine Talisman. Like, normally, I would definitely prioritize Artifact Mana over a 6-drop creature, but this one is just so much better than every other card that you could play in the 6-drop mana slot that it's worth taking a little higher. Basically, this card, like, only black decks can beat it once it comes into play. Because if they're trying to rely on sorcery speed removal, you've already gained too much advantage. Alright, so to go with my first pick blue card, I could take either of these powerful green cards, Channel or Garrick Primal Hunter. All is Dust is a fine card in a control deck, especially if you're fortunate enough to get like the powerful artifact mana like Thran Dynamo or Warren Power Stone. Preordain, obviously really, really great addition to any blue deck, and Court Hussar is also fine, and Rolling Earthquake is also fine. I would say that Garrick Primal Hunter is the most powerful card in the pack, so that's tempting, but Preordain is just going to be guaranteed, like I said, a guaranteed very good addition to my deck, and I don't really want to pass up an opportunity to get it, even for the sake of a more powerful card. Okay, and Tidings, pretty clear pick here. This is a card that I almost never pass. Definitely, in the top like 10 or 20 cards available in the cube. Card drawing is just way too good in a format like this where you can get fast mana and draw into board sweepers and other powerful cards. It's just exactly what you want. I also quite like Faith's Fetters in this pack. But that's about it. Okay, so Serum Visions, a tiny bit worse, but similar to Preordain, just going to be a really good addition to any blue deck. Deep Analysis is, the same things that I just said about Tidings apply to Deep Analysis, although I do consider it to be quite a bit worse. 6 mana to draw 4 is a lot, and I really don't like to pay life for my card drawing in a control deck, because in addition to investing a lot of mana and not impacting the board, if you're also paying life, that's likely to just set you too far behind against an aggro deck. So Deep Analysis is a card that, like, is still really powerful, but it's a little bit more passable than Tidings is. So, yeah, I'm just gonna kind of stay the course here and take Serum Visions. I think it's the safest pick. I'm also tempted by the Mana Elf, and, this card has some pretty high upside, although it can be a little bit challenging to use. Here I could take Blue Elemental Blast or Red Elemental Blast as sideboard cards. I could take Gaia's Cradle if I still want to plan for a green ramp deck, although that's certainly not the way things have been shaping up so far. Dismantling Blow or Hero's Downfall to branch into a second color, but to stay on the control route. I think I'm going to take one of the Elemental Blasts, and yeah, I guess it should be Blue Elemental Blast, although, like, this card is going to be so good against me, and if I do end up with access to red mana, it's going to be a much better sideboard card just because blue is a much better color. So I'm tempted to take the red elemental blast, but with no second color and no mana fixing thus far, this card is guaranteed to be useful for me, so I'll take it. Here I could take Coral Helm Commander, which is not exactly the type of card that I like in a deck like this. You know, if I go for a pure control deck with board sweepers, then I don't really want weenie creatures. I only want a couple of creatures that can really win the game on their own. That said, Coral Helm Commander, while it looks like a weenie, you know, can pretty quickly become a 4/4 flying, so it's fine. But I could also take Underground Sea or Memory Jar. Memory Jar going to be better in like a fast mana deck, you know, so let's say Green Ramp if I had the channel or something like that. I actually think that Underground Sea is probably the best pick here, because not only is it nice to pick up mana fixing early, but this is an actual dual land, which really, you know, in addition to just being by far the best mana fixing, it gains extra value because of all the fetch lands available in the queue. Alright, so following up that, I could take Rocky Tar Pit, a fetch land that can get Underground Sea. I'd probably be more likely to take Watery Grave just to double up on blue-black mana fixing. I could also take Feeding Magpie or Esper Charm, or Catastrophe, or Bane of the Living, I guess. Any of those would be reasonable. Watery Grave seems like the safest to me. So I've locked up pretty nice deck with some cheap card filtering, two good pieces of mana fixing, a sideboard card, and card drawing. I just need some cards that actually do something. But if I can get that, this deck will be really good. Mystical Tutor is a card that people tend to jump towards because it's like, you know, played in Vintage and banned in Legacy and stuff, but it's really not good in like an average deck because it's card disadvantage. You really only want it if you have like one insane card, you know, like an Ancestral Recall, for example, in Vintage that you can go for, or if you're trying to assemble a combo, but I don't seem to be doing either of those, so I'm definitely willing to pass up on Mystical Tutor. I could take Duress, Godless Shrine, Yavimaya Elder, or Noble Hierarch reasonably from this pack, but given that I have the two blue-black mana fixers, Duress seems really nice. This is a great card in cube. In addition to just being able to strip their most powerful card, it's good in counterspell mirrors, good to be able to see what your opponents are working with. It's just a great card. So here I could take O-Ring, Silent Spectre, Tundra, Reflecting Pool, or Johnny Goldmane. I guess I can't realistically take a Johnny Goldmane. I'm just going to take Tundra here. I don't think Silent Spectre is really, like, you know, it's a card, like I said, I only want a couple creatures if I'm building a control deck, and I think I can find better ones than Silent Spectre. Okay, great. Well, as you'll notice, Damnation did not wheel from my early pack, and that's one of the few sweepers available to blue-black. So the fact that that's already gone makes me a little bit tempted to pick this All is Dust. Phyrexian Rager and Court Hussar would also be fine, but this is the most unique, irreplaceable card, and I kind of want to just lock it up now. I'll definitely need to get some artifact mana if I want it to be at its best, but sometimes a slow, powerful card is still worth putting in your deck. Faith's Fetters is both more splashable and probably a little bit more efficient than a Chroma's Vengeance. I'll take that. I'm not sure if I'm going to be playing white or not. Kaiga is better than Silent Spectre. It's actually quite good. I would usually play it if I had it, but it's fairly replaceable. Again, only want a couple of those expensive creatures in my deck, and mana fixing like Underground River is not replaceable, so I'm going to take that. Oh, and the Red Elemental Blast wheels. So I think I'd rather just take this out of the draft and maybe have the chance to board it in if I pick up a couple of red dual lands, rather than taking Dismantling Blow, even though I do have the Tundra and the Faith Shredders. Interesting. Jeez. I'm going to take Blood Baron. And I'm going to take Esper Charm. So I do have cards in all of the Esper colors, and I have lands in all the Esper colors, but that doesn't mean I'm locked into playing full Esper. I still could go just blue-black, or I could go blue-black with a splash, or I could have an optional splash that I could bring in off the sideboard. Nothing's really set in stone yet, except that I'm playing blue. Okay. Well, this is a pretty clear Demonic Tutor. Similar to Mystical Tutor, this card is probably looks better than it is, but it's still really, really, really good. This one is not card disadvantage. Card goes straight to your hand, making it kind of like a super-duper preordained type card. But also, you know, in a deck where I have a couple powerful cards, like finishers, and, you know, might have one board sweeper, Demonic Tutor is able to really steer me in the direction that I'm going to need to go in any particular game. I'm definitely going to take that here and stay on track for a blue-black control deck. Misty Rainforest would also be nice. Even though I'm not playing green, it can search for both Tundra and Underground Sea. So a blue fetchland is a little bit hard to pass here, but Demonic Tutor is even more hard to pass. Wow, some nice options here. Remand, Ancestral Vision, and Liliana Vess. All really, really great cards, but of them, Ancestral Vision is the best. Similar to Tidings, a card that I almost never pass in Hue Draft. Here the options are Forspike, Doomblade, Night's Whisper, Elspeth Tyrell, and Parallax Wave, I guess. Not really considering Parallax Wave, though. I'm just going to take Doomblade. Like I said, I'm not going to have as many sweepers as I might if I was playing a base white deck and picking up a really efficient instant speed removal spell. Spot removal spell is nice. It also happens to be one of the few ways to deal with Consecrated Sphinx, so taking it out of the draft has a little bit of value to me. I think it's a pretty clear pick here. Now, when you watch me, you know, do like a Born of the Gods Theros booster draft, I'm usually starting to hide a bunch of cards by this point in the draft, but it's a little more challenging in Cube because there's a lot of mana fixing, so you want to know exactly what you stand to gain by taking a dual land, or exactly what you stand to gain by taking a possible sideboard card, depending on what mana fixing might come later. Anyway. This is a fine card. This is a good card, but not in my color. This is a great card that I'm probably going to pick. This is a good card, but not for me. This is a fine card. This is a great card, but probably not as good as Counterspell. And this is a great card also. And this is a great card also. But of them, Counterspell is the one that is easiest for me to use and the most important to my deck. I don't expect it, but the card I'd be happiest to wield is Celestial Colonnade out of here. I also really, really like Marshall Coup, but having 2/7 mana sweepers is not exactly the perfect setup. Also, I don't know if I'm playing white yet. Okay, so this is one of the more powerful and unique cards that's been added to the cube recently. Definitely is at odds with what I'm trying to do in my deck, but I don't want to play against it, so it's worth noting that I'm passing it here. I'm going to have to think about that in deck construction and gameplay. This card's going to be really, really hard for my deck to beat. But anyway, I could take Terminus, Gideon, Bloodstainmire, Moloku, or Master of Waves. And I'm going to take Bloodstainmire for the same reason that it can get my Underground Sea. So it's effectively a second copy of that dual land. Also, if I wanted to bring in Red Elemental Blast off the sideboard, this card helps me. I wouldn't mind having Moloku or Master of Waves, and I wouldn't mind counterdrafting Winter Orb, but I think I need Bloodstainmire more than those things. Okay, so I could take Daze, or Dissipate, or Augur of Bolas, or Skeletal Scrying. Or I could take Obsidian if I wanted to be extremely ambitious with my mana, but the way things are shaping up, I probably want mostly basic islands in my deck, and can't cast Obsidian by tapping two basic islands, so I'm not interested in that. I think I probably want Daze. If I didn't have a couple better card drawing spells, I might be interested in the Skeletal Scrying, but like I said, I don't like paying life with my card drawing, and I don't like it to have too much setup required. Daze and Dissipate's a close call, but I like Daze quite a bit. Augur of Bolas is also fine, but I don't like missing with cards like that. Spending 2 mana for 1/3 and whiffing is pretty awful. Okay, here I could take Into the Royal Miscalculation, Swords to Plashers, or Volcanic Island. I guess this is the point where I really need to decide if I want to play white, because Swords to Plashers is probably too good to pass if I have white in my deck. So far, I have only one white mana fixer. Bloodstainmire can't get Tundra, and I have a pretty good blue-black deck shaping up, so I don't really want to go deep into a third color if I don't have to. Think I want Miscalculation more than anything else here. This is a really close pick. I could see any of these four cards being the right call here, but I know that Counterspells are really good, so I'm just going to go with that Miscalculation. Jeez, okay, along those same lines, Force of Will is a great, great card that I would really like for my deck here. Flooded Strand is also huge. If I had taken Swords to Plashers, I would have to definitely go for Flooded Strand here, and as it stands, it'd still be a nice pickup, as it can get Underground Sea or Tundra. But Force of Will is going to get the slight nod here. This card is really, really, really good. This doesn't exactly seem like a Dark Ritual deck to me. I want to just make my land drops, so I think, you know, playing something like an 18th land is going to be better than playing Dark Ritual. My deck's not that explosive. So that leaves Arid Mesa. If I do decide to play white, it can get the Tundra, it can get a Mountain for Red Elemental Blast, or if I am able to pick up something like, let's say, a Badlands, then I could play Arid Mesa to fetch Tundra or Badlands. I don't know, basically just picking up the fetch lands is pretty powerful in Cube because of the way they interact with dual lands, and sometimes you can make weird things happen with half off-color or full off-color fetch lands. I'm going to take Land Tax here. It is the most powerful card, the card I'm most likely to use, and the card I least want to face. Probably not going to make my deck, given that white is going to be a splash or not played at all. None of these cards are going to make the cut in my deck. So I guess I'll just take the land. I don't know. It doesn't really matter. Any of these five cards would be fine, and it's pretty unlikely to matter. Wow, Marshall Coup came around really late. Steam Augury is also a consideration. Similar to Skeletal Scrying, if I didn't already have better card drawing, I would be more likely to consider Steam Augury. But it's just like pretty bad. And also, cards like Steam Augury and Factor Fiction lose value the fewer win conditions you have in your deck. Because, you know, like, let's say you have 3 win conditions in your deck, which is pretty light. I hope to have more than that. But anyway, let's say for the sake of argument, you have 3. One's already died, or it got thoughts used or something. Then you reveal one to your Factor Fiction. It's really, really hard to put that second win condition in the graveyard, because then you're drawing thin on the third one. The third one could die, or it could be too near the bottom of your library.